is on.
Love it or hate it, hundreds of people have designs like this emblazoned on their bodies every year in the capital. Tattooists say it's a fine art. Ben Gunn's been running his tattoo studio here in Chingford for the last 35 years. But while many establishments like this one are hygienically safe, health officers say there are plenty of rogue ones which are putting people's lives at risk. Needles may be dirty, along with the premises some tattooists use. Hepatitis B or even AIDS could be contracted. And according to environmental health officers, it's not just tattooing which can be dangerous, but also ear piercing, electrolysis and acupuncture. Some councils in the capital have already adopted new controls under last year's London Local Authorities Act to ensure safety standards are maintained. But some, like Southwark, are only now introducing the new bylaws. Now the money's available to oversee the project.
What particular bits of hygiene should they really be looking at?
Where possible, always use disposable sterile equipment. But where it is unavoidable, they must only use it for one customer at a time. Particularly where tattooists are concerned, that is using pigments only for one customer and not using them again.
Like years ago, people used to come for a tattoo, they didn't worry about anything. But they worry about this AIDS thing. But they don't worry about, if you don't mind saying, syphilis, gonorrhea. That could all be caught off of a tattooing needle if it isn't done correctly. So always go to a proper tattooist.
And you weren't worried about possibility that, you know, it could be dangerous or anything like that?
No, I went in today. I found out that they sterilised their needles and they put stuff on it, and I'd only ever come here anyway.
It's hoped more people will be as happy about their tattoos as Wendy, thanks to the new rules. Githa Hutton, Thames News.